Great. Andrew and Duncan, what about you? Did you do the shopping list?
She's got cream soda and hot cross buns.
Yeah, well, you needed her milk, didn't you? Which yeah, Jane yeah. was. Well, Jane got. Never mind. No £100 there. You got a mini sweep earlier. That's £25 onto your subtotal. Yeah. But you got a bonus. How much is that worth?
£75.
Good. Gives you a subtotal of £100. If when we add that £100 to the value of the goods in your trolley and it is more than 142, you're going to run the super sweep. If it isn't, it'll be Jane and Debs. When we add those two totals together, you have a grand total on supermarket sweep today of £384. You're running the super sweep. Jane and Debs, Mandy and Nancy, thanks for being great shoppers. You'll get a parting gift. Have a good day. Thanks very much. Right. Somewhere out there in that supermarket is £2,000 hidden in cash. It's yours for the taking. You have 1 minute to find it. To find the money, you have to solve the three clues that will lead you to the three specially marked products. Are you ready?
Yep.
I'll give you the first clue and your minute doesn't start until after I've done that. Here's your first one. Some fats are liquid, others are hard. Butter's not liquid and neither is...
Blank.
Blank. We're going to stick alive. Here, Andy. Read it out. Read it out. These elegant thin crackers you might get at the Hilton cost something biscuits go so very well with Ritz, the finest Ritz biscuits. Take care. Okay. Ritz biscuits. Biscuits. You see them? I look.
You just got them in time. Fortunately, you didn't get it quick enough, really, I guess. But never mind. Listen, you're going home with the value of the goods in your trolley, which gives you today on supermarket sweep £284. Will that do for you?
Yep.
Good. Have a good day. Thanks for joining us in the market today. And remember, the next time you're at the checkout and you hear that beep, think of the fun you could be having on supermarket sweep. Have a good day.
Congratulations, number three. You said cup of tea. That's the top answer. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Don't miss final reductions on sofas, beds and dining this bank holiday. But hurry, it's the last few days of the Furniture Village sale.
Your dog's gorgeous.
Isn't she?
Can you believe we got her to protect our home?
Verisure Alarm is all you need. 24/7 monitoring. Get to check on Crusher if you pop out.
Good idea.
Isn't it, Crusher?
Verisure Alarms. Get a free indoor camera installed with your Zero Vision alarm installation. Call now or visit verisure.co.uk.
Which would you choose? This robot vacuum cleaner? Or this one from Woucher? Woucher. Save now. Live wow.
At Freeprints, we make printing the moments that matter easy. That's why we're the UK's biggest photo printing app. And more than that, we're called Freeprints for a reason. You get 45 photo prints every month for free. Just pay delivery. And we're trusted by more than 10 million customers. Download the Freeprints app today.
The reigning champion.
Max Verstappen, reigning supreme.
Back on home shores.
For me, it's definitely a very special weekend.
In a mission to make it three home wins in a row.
Double Dutch delight for Max Verstappen.
And with the sea of orange out in full force.
Turn up to the max. Listen to that roar.
Good luck trying to stop him.
See, you wouldn't want to be you, says Max.
Yes.
The Heineken Dutch Grand Prix. To add Sky Sports, go to sky.com/sports.
I beat him once. I beat him twice.
Smith Eubank Jr. 2, live on Sky Sports Box Office.
Give us a clickety-click if you can still hear us. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Are you ready to go shopping? Step inside a very special supermarket. The only supermarket in the world that gives you money. £2,000 is waiting on our shelves to be won by some lucky person in this store. The aim of the game is to shop smarter and faster than the next person. And everything in this supermarket is up for grabs. Go on, fill your trolley as high as you can, because shopping has never been so much fun. Yes, there's prizes in store and much, much more when you play Supermarket Sweep. So let's welcome today's shoppers. And they are Irene and Yvonne from Stockport, Janet and Alan from Worcestershire, and Christine and Carol from Essex. You're all on Supermarket Sweep. And here's your host, Dale Winton.
Good morning, teams. And good morning to you. Welcome to Supermarket Sweep. This could be the day that one of our teams goes home with the £2,000. It's out there somewhere. All you have to do is prove your knowledge of shopping skills and what goes on in the supermarket, and in so doing, build up those valuable and vital minutes and seconds. And that is the time our shoppers will take out there into the market for the sweeps. The more time you have, the more shopping you get to do. I'll start you all off with a minute apiece. There you go. And as a little taster of what you'll be doing much later on in the show, we're going to run a mini sweep, a chance to pick up 10 seconds straight away and a possible £25 bonus. Are you ready to play?
Yes, Dale. Yes,
what product am I looking for? In bygone days, a husband would irreverently refer to his wife as an old one. So that's a clue to the freshwater fish we're seeking. Carol.
Trout.
Sounds right, and it is 10 seconds. Not a nice thing to call someone's wife, is it, really? But anyway, you've just added 10 seconds to your clocks. Christine, you're going to run the mini sweep. Somewhere out there is the trout bearing the sweep logo. If you bring it to me within half a minute, I'll add £25 to your sweep total. Are you ready?
I am.
Off you go. Christine, I like the way you sort of casually looked at the freezer and made us all wait, and you knew where it was all the time. Well done. I just added £25 to your sweep total. Go back and join Carol. Irene and Yvonne, good morning. Welcome to Supermarket Sweep.
Good morning, Dale.
How are you both?
Fine, thank you. Fine.
Ready to go wild in our aisles?
Yes.
You've been friends for how long?
2 years.
Right. And I know that it's an unusual story because you met in a very unusual way. What happened, Yvonne?
Well, I was coming out to my house and Irene was passing by with her little baby girl. And she asked me the way to a mother and baby group and I was going to the same one. So we just walked and that was it, wasn't it?
She's not let you go.
Never looked back.
She's not let you go since.
No. I felt so sorry for her being on her own.
Oh. Ah.
Well, welcome both of you to the programme today and to our Thank supermarket. You. Do you go shopping together as well?
No. Now and again, don't we? Once or twice.
Oh, a little argument really. Here in the morning. Really? Never mind, never mind. I wish you both lots of luck today on the sweep. Welcome.
Thank you.
Alan and Janet, good morning.
Good morning, Dale.
Married for how long?
Nearly 10 years.
He was thinking, I hope she knows the answer to that. I'm only joking, I'm only joking. And what is it about him that makes him one of the best husbands you could possibly marry to?
Sings nicely.
Yeah, well, I gather that's something that you like to be professionally as a musician singer.
I'd love to. Getting a bit old, really.
Nonsense, there's no such thing. You like the beard?
Yes.
What sort of music would you like to do professionally?
Well, I do contemporary folk music, usually, but I've got quite wide-ranging tastes.
And a large repertoire?
Quite a large repertoire, yes. If I knew
it's
what
a bit
it
early
meant.
In the morning for that kind of word, isn't it? I know, I know. Well, welcome to the suite. Have a great time in our supermarket.
Thank you, Dale.
Christine and Carol, good morning.
Good morning, Dale.
Sisters.
Yes.
Sisters. Well, I won't say who's the oldest or the youngest, because that really would not be... You're not twins, though, are you?
No.
No. And do you spend much time together?
Yes, quite a lot, yeah. We live near each other.
Right. And where is that? It's Essex, I believe.
Yes.
Is it Essex? Okay. And what about sort of children and things like that? Carol, do you have any children?
No, I don't. No?
What about you, Chris?
Yeah, I have two. I have a little boy of two and a daughter of eight.
So where do you leave them when you go shopping?
Preferably with my parents, if I can.
Well, good luck today. It's lovely to have you both on the sweep. Welcome. Okay, we're going to play a game. Yvonne, Janet and Carol, we will see a little bit later on, but Christine, Alan and Irene, step forward. Let's play a game. This is the game I call First and Last. What that means is I'm going to give you the first letter and the last letter of the answer I'm looking for. I'll also supplement it with a series of clues. Simply buzz in as soon as you know what the answer is. And there are possible 50 seconds up for grabs here. Are you ready to play?
Yes.
Here we go. Begins with a C and ends in an E. Red. Fizzy. Drink. Christine.
Cherryade.
That sounds right, and it is. 10 seconds, well done. Three words here, beginning with a D and ending in an E. Dinner, not sweet, not red. Alcohol, drink. Irene.
Dry white wine.
The best kind, absolutely. 10 seconds, good. Begins with an S and ends with an L. Hot or cold, snack. Irene.
Sausage roll.
Certainly right, 10 seconds. This one begins with an S and ends with an E. Tomatoes. Pasta. Irene.
Spaghetti bolognese.
I think that's right. 10 seconds. And if you want to let Alan and Christine have a go, I'm sure they won't mind.
No.
This one begins with an I and ends with an R. Dairy. Melts. Spread. Dublin. Knob. Dairy, melts, spread, Dublin, knob. Alan.
Irish butter.
That's absolutely right. 10 seconds. You didn't take me at my word, though, did you, Irene?
You took it off me, didn't you?
Yeah,
I did.
Sorry about that. We're going to play the calorie round now. What that means is we're going to find out just how much you know about that which you eat, in terms of how many calories in food and drink. Get the idea? OK, here we go. Which of these three products has the most calories per 100 grams? Have a look at these three. Damson jam, fig rolls, or golden syrup. Please make a choice. One, two, or three. Damson for the one, two for the fig rolls, and three for the golden syrup. Irene, which one did you decide had the most calories?
Three.
Three, you said the golden syrup. Alan?
Three.
Golden syrup, two. And Christine?
Three.
The golden syrup. I'm going to surprise you now, because it surprised me too. The damson jam has 254 calories per 100 grams. The fig rolls, 338. And the syrup, 298. So the answer I was looking for was two, the fig rolls. That's a surprise, isn't it? Which of these three has the most calories per 100 grams? Horseradish sauce, ketchup, or mint jelly? Please make a choice, one, two, or three. Irene, which one did you decide had the most calories per 100 grams?
Two.
You said two, the ketchup. Alan?
One.
The horseradish sauce. And Christine?
One down.
One, the horseradish sauce. Well, let me tell you, this is an unusual one too. The horseradish has 185 per 100 grams, the ketchup 123, and the mint jelly 276. The reason being, of course, mint sauce, not mint jelly. The mint jelly, I mean, the mint sauce only has 18 calories, so that's probably what threw you there. But never mind, let's have another calorie game. Of these following three, which one of these has the most calories per 100 grams? Cheesecake, cheese sauce, or cheese spread? Make your choice, one, two, or three. Irene.
One.
One, you said the cheesecake. Alan.
One, though.
Cheesecake. And Christine.
One.
You've all gained 10 seconds, absolutely right. 420 calories. I'll tell you that the cheese sauce has 127 and the spread 283. That's good. Let's bring back your partners. OK, welcome back. Let's have a look at how much time you now have on your clocks. Well, Janet and Alan, you have 1 minute and 20. Carol and Christine, you have 1 minute and 30. And Yvonne and Irene, 1 minute and 40. Well done. Good. Irene, Alan and Christine, we will see you later for the round robin, but returning players, step forward, we're going to play a game. Right, this is the gossip round. This is when we scour the magazines and the newspapers to find out all about the rich and famous. So I don't know how well up you are on those. Are you? Looking worried, Janet. Never mind. I think you'll have no problem with this one. Possible 40 seconds for you to make on this particular game. I'm going to give you the list of 6 famous supermodels. Here they are. Naomi Campbell, Cindy Crawford, Yasmin Lebon, Claudia Schiffer, Iman, and Christy Brinkley. I want you to match the star to the model. Here we go. Here's your first one. Richard Gere. Yvonne.
Cindy Crawford.
Sounds right. It is 10 seconds. Billy Joel. Janet.
Iman.
Let's see if you're right. Carol.
Chrissy Brinkley.
Sounds right, is it? Yeah, 10 seconds. Which one of our lovelies used to be very, very romantically linked with Adam Clayton of Yvonne?
Claudia Schiffer.
See if you're right. No. Janet and Carol, do you still want to have a go? Adam Clayton of U2? Janet.
Iman.
Let's see if you're right. No, you can still go, Carol. Carol.
Naomi Campbell.
She certainly did, yeah, absolutely. Well done, 10 seconds. And here's your last chance in the gossip round. David Bowie.
Yvonne.
Iman, absolutely right. Well done, Yvonne. 10 seconds. Let's have a look at those clocks, see how well you did in the gossip round. Well, Janet, you have 1 minute and 20. Carol, you have 1 minute and 50. And Yvonne, you have 2 minutes. Before you got here this morning, I had a quick whiz around the supermarket and I picked 3 items off the shelves. What I can tell you is that when we add all the values of the 3 products together, it doesn't come to £4. Okay, what we have pure olive oil, we have Crofter's pie, and we have Colombian filter coffee. What I want to know is, would it come to more or less than £4? Is it higher or lower, in other words? So please, make your choice. And what I can tell you is, if you get the answer right, I'll give you 10 seconds. If all 3 of you agree, I'll throw in a bonus 20 seconds, so it's possible for all 3 of you to collect a full half a minute. Please make your choice, higher or lower. Yvonne, did you think it was more or less than £4?
Less.
Less. Janet?
More.
You said more. And Carol?
More.
You said more. Well, let me tell you, the olive oil is £1.79. The Crofter's pie is also £1.79. And the coffee is £1.29. When you add those together, it comes to £4.87. More was the answer. Higher was what I was looking for. So, Janet and Carol, you've just added 10 seconds to your clock. Let's bring back your partners. Welcome back. Let's have a look at those clocks. Well, Alan and Janet, you have 1 minute and 30, and 2 minutes for Irene and Yvonne, and the same 2 minutes for Christine and Carol. Your last chance to add a full 1 minute to your scores in the round robin. What that means is you take it in turns to answer correctly. For returning players, you're going to go first, so step forward. And we call this the quickie. Buzz in as soon as you know the answer. Here we go. What do Gorgonzola, Roquefort and Stilton cheeses have in... Christine?
They're goat's cheese.
Let's see if that's right. That's not what I'm looking for. What do those have in common? Alan and Irene, you can still play. Alan?
They're blue cheeses.
Absolutely right. 10 seconds. Blue vein cheese. Well done. Change. What on a clothes label does a hand in water represent? Janet?
Hand wash only.
Absolutely. 10 seconds. Change. What type of remedy contains calcium carbonate? Alan.
Indigestion remedy?
You obviously don't suffer with it, but you're quite right. 10 seconds, change. Which comedian had a vegetable-sounding name and a TV show? Carol.
Jasper Carrot.
He did. 10 seconds, change. What are crudities? Christine.
They're sliced vegetables to have with dips.
That sounds right to me. 10 seconds, change. The cocktail screwdriver is orange juice with which... Carol.
Vodka.
Oh, do you drink it?
Yes.
Yeah, 10 seconds, well done. That takes care of the round robin. I think you all added to your clocks on that particular one. Let's have a look at how much time you're taking with you out there into the market for the sweep. Yvonne and Irene, 2 minutes. Alan and Janet, also 2 minutes. And Christine and Carol, 2 minutes 30. So tell me, which one of each team is going to be running the sweep? Irene, Janet and Carol. I wish you luck. Come back in a few moments' time and we'll watch those three running wild through the aisles, loading their trolleys for that chance to go for the £2,000 here on Supermarket Sweep.
Congratulations, 82. You're straight on through to the next round.
Oh, God.
Come and look at these old photos of Grandad.
Oh, I miss him. But at least he had a good send-off. He must have saved up like mad. What's a funeral cost these days?
About £4,000. And by the time he had all the extras, it's more like £6,000. Thankfully, Grandad had proper life insurance. And now I do too.
British Seniors has been chosen by more than 200,000 people across Britain to protect their families. With a guaranteed cash payout up to £10,000 and 100% of claims paid, prices start from just £4.32 a month. If you're a UK resident aged 50 to 80, you're guaranteed to be accepted with no medicals or blood tests. And when you take out a policy, you'll receive a free £125 gift card.
Come on, you. Nap time. You need your sleep so you can be smart like your nan. Yes, you do.
To get a quote, call our friendly UK team now on 0800 093 3345 or search British Seniors Over 50s.
They did us proud. They're still winners in my eyes.
Oh, did they win a shirt as well? Win your official shirt with Weetabix.
Avoid malware-ridden files. Zen. Be more cyber zen. Get Nord VPN.
Hello, savings!
Yes, Log. In the Dreams up to 50% off sleep sale, till Tuesday there's 20% off all Silent Night mattresses.
Dreams.
Macmillan Coffee Morning is back this September. So let's get together and do whatever it takes for people living with cancer. Whether you're making it, baking it, even faking it. Dancing, laughing, family gathering, or just coffee and chatting. The money you raise helps us do whatever it takes for people living with cancer. There's still time to join in. Order your free coffee morning kit today by searching Macmillan Coffee Morning now.
Roll up, roll up! Prepare to be amazed. Feel the magic up close.
It's belief and delirium!
With Matoma the Magician, feel your hair raising with Puppet Master Pep.
Pep Guardiola is a genius.
Hold on to your hats. It's Bruno the...
Brilliant! Quite brilliant! Oh, it's fabulous! A strike to get you up off your seats!
To add Sky Sports, go to sky.com/sports.
Oh, Queen Bee, you've buzzed too early again.
Welcome back to Supermarket Sweep. Now, we saw our teams build up that time on their clocks earlier. That is the time they're going to use to go wild in the aisles, something I've always wanted to do, and you're going to do it right now. Let's have a look at just how much time you do have. Well, Carol and Christine, you have 2 minutes and 30. Irene and Yvonne, you have 2 minutes. And Janet and Alan, you also have 2 minutes. So, go wild, grab as much as you possibly can. Everything out there in the supermarket is yours for the taking. Only 3 items of any one category. And don't forget, if you knock a cameraman over or you drop something off a shelf, there'll be a penalty. So pick something up if you let it fall. Don't forget my shopping list as well. It's worth £100 on your subtotal. Here's what's on today's list. A packet of cream crackers, a kitchen roll, and a white cabbage. If you bring back all three, I'll add £100 to your subtotal. Partners, remind the shoppers when they come back to change trolleys what's on the list. Also, keep an eye out for the inflatable bonuses. They're all over the supermarket and worth between £25 and £100. Grab one, it can only help your subtotal. Are you ready to go shopping?
Yes.
Good. I'm going to count you in. Carol and Christine, you're going to go first. 3, 2, 1, go!
Go, Carol!
Go, Carol, says Christine. And with a 30-second time advantage, no wonder she's got a smile on her face. But Carol's putting that advantage to good use there with dishwasher powder and toilet roll. Yep, up we go. Where to now? I don't know. Up here. Bread bins, why not? 1, 2, 3 of those. Looking good. Round the corner, into the dairy section. Come on, shout the audience. Getting behind Carol. Go, Irene's away. And, oh, straight into the... She got the white cabbage, all right. Janet's got some CDs. She's off, up and running. All three of them at it now. Bread bin there for Janet. There's Carol putting in the white cabbage. That's on Dal's shopping list. Here goes Irene. Got a couple of turkeys there, picking up a dustbin. What's Janet up to? Into the toilet rolls. Duvet and a pillow there for Carol. My word, this is a frantic sweep. Irene going around the corner, trying to... hardly call it careful shopping, can you? Look at Irene getting some beers. Janet gets a fresh trolley, and she's off. Has she remembered where that... Oh, she's all over the place. She went through the chicane there and nearly rolled it. Into frozen foods, up into the dairy. Here's Carol, whooshing down the line, still smiling. And what's Irene doing? Oh, look at this. She's never going to make it. She can't steer. She's all over the place. This is pandemonium. And she's... Janet's just taken time out for a beer. And who can blame her? She's tried those beers. I bet that fish has got a headache. They went straight on his head with some flask to follow. There's Irene racing down the aisle. Carol's picked up some nappies. And it's all changed there for Janet as well. Kitchen rolls. Come on. She's piled higher. Hello. Oh, my word. That pillow's brought on a bit of a nightmare for Janet, because unless she picks the bottles up of concentrated juice, then she's going to be penalised. Here's Irene. She's dropped something as well. Penalties all over the place. The place is in chaos. There's Carol putting some bread rolls in there. Back at the checkout, Janet picks up a new trolley and she's off and running again. There's a duvet and some kitchen rolls for Irene. And time's up. It's back to the checkout.
Come on back. Come on back. Come on back, Janet. Come on. We're, by the way, Bobby, thanks for a great, great talk over during that wild, run wild through the aisles. We're going to let Caroline, Sam and Justin run all these groceries through the totals, find out which one of these three are going to go for the £2,000. Let's add up these groceries now. OK, well, let's see just how well you did. Now, Janet and Alan, did you do my shopping list?
Afraid not, sir, Dale.
A bit.
A bit?
A bit.
I can't even give you a bit of £100 I offered you. Never mind, Janet. But you have a very, very fishy-looking bonus. There's a salmon. How much is your bonus worth, Alan?
£75.
Great. So, you have a subtotal of £75. Let's add that subtotal to the value of the goods in your trolley, which today on Supermarket Sweep gives you a grand total of £266. That's good. Irene and Yvonne, any shopping list from you?
That's all.
Two out of three ain't bad. Can't give you any £100. What about an inflatable bonus?
No.
Oh, dear. Well, tell you what, we'll take into consideration the value of the shopping in your trolley, which today gives you a grand total of £195. You did well. That's good. Carol and Christine, let's have a look here. Mini sweep earlier, that's £25. Did you do a full shopping list?
No, we couldn't find the cream crackers.
Couldn't find the cream. Oh, they're there. They're there. And what about the inflatable bonus?
No.
Oh, dear. Well, we'll add your subtotal of £25 to the value of the shopping in your trolley. If it is more than £266, you're going to run the super sweep. If it isn't, it'll be Janet and Alan. When we add that subtotal together with the value of your goods, you have a grand total today of £211. Very good, well done. Janet and Alan, you're running the super sweep. Irene and Yvonne, Carol and Christine, thanks for being great shoppers today. You'll get a parting gift and have a good day. Thank you for joining us. I've got to tell you, Alan, when I said what the total was and that you were going through, your face was a picture and a half.
Oh, was it? Oh.
You were so surprised. You were so surprised. Are you ready to go for the money, Janet?
Yeah.
It's out there somewhere. Shall I tell you where it is?
Yes, please.
No. But I will tell you, to find the money and keep it, you have to do that within 1 minute. You have to solve the clues that will lead you to the three specially marked products. I'm going to give you the first clue. And I'm not going to start the clock until after I've told you what it is. So you have a full minute. Are you ready to go shopping?
Yes. Ready?
Good. Here we go. If your husband dislikes marmalade and he really is a nutter, he'd like instead a piece of bread with crunchy blank butter.
Peanut butter.
Go, 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 go.
Southern, left, 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 left.
Yes! Your husband likes his poultry curries hot. Or at least distinctly warmer. But if you prefer your curries mild,
you choose.
So you choose. Corner.
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 Chicken corner.
Chicken pot. Chicken corner. Chicken corner.
Indian, Indian.
Yes!
If your child refuses all dried food because of the taste he hates, the one exception's bound to be some chopped and sticky
dates. Dates. This one.
Dried fruits.
Dates.
Dried fruits.
No, we're not in it.
It's not here.
Come on back. Come on back. Oh, you so close, so close. You want me to have the curry? Listen, let me tell you, you're going
dates.
Home. It's dates. It is dates. I'm going to show you where they are in just a moment. But in the meantime, let me tell you, you're going home with the value of the shopping in your trolley today. So you did very, very well. Have you had a good day?
Great, thank great. You.
Good. Yes, well, thanks for being great shoppers with us. Well, that takes care of another supermarket sweep. Join us next time. And don't forget, whenever you're out shopping and you're at the supermarket and you hear the beep, think of the fun you could be here having on Supermarket Sweep.
You've made us wait long enough. What's your final answer? Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Help your kids get to grips with their cash with NatWest Rooster Money. They can save for what they want, manage their money, and even help out to earn extra cash. You'll get alerts and can easily top them up. Download the app and sign up for your Rooster card. First month free, then $1.99 a month. Search NatWest Rooster Money in your app store. NatWest, tomorrow begins today.
Holidays always cost more than you expect, don't they? The new pair of sunglasses at the airport, the cheeky lunchtime pina colada. With Lebara, one cost you don't have to worry about is EU roaming charges. Because, unlike most networks, with Lebara, there aren't any. They're all about saving you money. Just like this ad. No Hollywood actors here. That's why they hired me, Layla from Pearly.
Lebara, smarter.
Yes, could I get a pina colada?
Life doesn't come with a manual. There's trial and error. You can be taught to tick the right box and be inspired to discover what's inside. Because in this world of wonder, fortune favours the fascinated. At Explore Learning, we are champions of curiosity, cheerleaders for the can-do. We believe in learning for life, because you're not in it for the short term, and neither are we. Explore Learning.
The
reigning champion.
Max Verstappen, reigning supreme.
Back on home shores.
For me, it's definitely a very special weekend.
In a mission to make it three home wins in a row.
Double Dutch delight for Max Verstappen.
And with the sea of orange out in full force.
Turn up to the max! Listen to that roar!
Good luck trying to stop him.
See, you wouldn't want to be here, says Max.
Yes!
The Heineken Dutch Grand Prix. To add Sky Sports, go to sky.com/sports.
Congratulations, number three. You said cup of tea. That's the top answer. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Thank you very much indeed. Hello, good evening, and welcome to Through the Keyhole, the show that visits the homes of the famous and reveals secrets which are, you must promise me now, to go no further. Tonight, as always, we're looking at the keys of two engrossing homes, taking them with us to find out what well-known personalities are living there. With Lloyd Grossman's help, we'll be taking a privileged peep behind closed doors. But the question is, whose? Well, to try and answer that question, we have three charming and perceptive connoisseurs of all that is beautiful in life. Where are they, you ask? First of all, it's always a pleasure to welcome a guest whose talent, integrity and sincerity have made him a household name in the television industry. But instead, would you welcome William Rushton? Secondly, a young actress and singer and writer so famous that her name is on half the water taps in Paris, Miss Emma Freud. And finally, making his first appearance on television since his recent charisma transplant, Mr. Chris Tarrant. Well, now, let me tell you a little bit about the game. With the aid of our famous key, we'll be taking a careful look inside two fascinating homes. And that should tell us something about the people who live there, the person or people. All that our friends over there have got to do is to try and work out who that is. So let's join Lloyd straight away at house number one. And watch closely, because remember, the clues are there as we go through the keyhole.
Well, this is a fine example of a pre-electric doorbell. Well, these are double doors for very thin people, and no wonder they're thin, because they're terribly sporting. They're interested in walking, riding, rugby, and perhaps handball. Well, this dining room is not just for display. It has the feeling and the appearance of a very well-used, well-worn room. This is a no-nonsense dining table, and I think these people really enjoy their food. They're quite serious about good eating here. They're quite an intellectual family. I love this library. Very wide range of interests on display here. Now, there's a wee Scotty in the corner. And there's some Scottish items on the dresser. So these people are quite keen on Scotland. Even though they've got the obligatory picture of cows on a cloudy day, this is not at all a dour room. Just look at the mantel shelf with brightly colored bits of glass and a rather clever brass menagerie. There are animals in the study too, although these are rather more exotic and suggest that someone here might be fond of the occasional safari. I like that object in the corner. It shows a nicely macabre sense of humor. Now, this family definitely subscribe to the work ethic. They're terribly industrious, and a lot of heavy reading, writing, and thinking goes on in this room. Indeed, they almost seem a tiny bit guilty about leisure. Look at the way those games are hidden away. And I see that they're practitioners of the ancient Scottish art of outdoor weaving. Wonderful collection of eggs here. Maybe someone in the house is nervous and likes fidgeting with them, or perhaps they're souvenirs because they seem to come from all different places. These people like traveling. There are a lot of mementos of far-flung locations here. Now, once again, this room is rather un-Scottish. Look at this sexy sofa, for example. And I see over there is Lucretia Borgia's dresser. It's quite an impressive piece of furniture. On the windowsill, we've got more exotica from Africa and especially from Arabia. This knife seems to be bent, though. I noticed that someone is very fond of vintage cars as well. So maybe one member of this family is a bit of a lad. Let's look at the evidence. The wee Scotty. The hidden games. The apothecary's chest. Who lives in a house like this? David, it's over to you.
Well, thank you very much indeed, Lloyd. And so now, for our home and studio audience, though not for our panel, here's whose house it is. Willie, it's your turn to start the analysis.
What a poser, Dave. My word.
It is a poser, isn't it, Will?
In Lloyd's honour, I'm wearing the Boston Red Sox. Yeah.
As a tribute to Lloyd, right.
Antique golf bag in the hall made me think instantly royal and ancient. Then I thought, no, the Queen Mother wouldn't travel this far north just for the money they pay for, yeah. Then the books, good to see, very rare. Many of these homes we go to on this programme, you see no books whatsoever. In fact, in many cases, they may clear them out of the house. Hong Kong 1983 and the Nuclear Something were the only two I managed to get the titles of. But anyway, these people obviously read, and they've got a great plate, signed to the Order of the Thistle. It may not be that the person who lives in that house now is Order of the Thistle, but it has something to do with the Order of the Thistle, which points towards Scotland, because the thistle is no use for anybody outside of me. Hippo... And right, they travel. Idi Amin's shrunken head, I thought was an interesting and quite lively thing to have on your bookshelf. So really, by looking, some possible member of the royal family who's been to Hong Kong in 1983 may or may not have the Order of the Thistle and is into shrunken heads of former leaders of African states.
So interesting summary. Now, do you agree with that, Emma?
This is terribly difficult, you know. Mm. Much harder than you thought. Yeah, I'm very confused in this one. I saw that game Election X, which we have in our house, and I think is in every house where people know nothing about politics. Obviously, someone who knows nothing about politics. Oh. That narrows it down to about 7 million, then. Scottish. I first thought of Les McEwan, but then there was a picture of a 14-year-old child, and I don't think... Do you know who Les McEwan is, David?
More or less.
Yes, basically two rivers. That's right. I know you're quite a raver. The Brass Menagerie, somebody with a very tacky taste. I mean, they're horrible, those things, aren't they? The Candles, obviously someone who likes a bit of a romantic evening for two. That's as far as I got so far. Chris.
Christopher.
Well, there's so many red herrings in amongst all this. I mean, it's someone who's very fat, eats a lot, and has a lot of sex on the sofa, which... could be almost any member of the royal family. There's a seal in the audience. There was actually, in amongst all this stuff like games and so on, there were two or three things that I thought only a member of parliament or somebody political could have one. It's somebody...
You see, that links up. That was the reason for the applause during Emma,
there were things that nobody in their right mind except a member of parliament or a politician or a political correspondent or someone would have. So it's someone who knows something, probably not a lot, about politics.
Right. The field is narrowing, William.
So, it's Scottish-ish, politician-ish. The only person who fills the bill totally there is David Steele.
Will you welcome David Steele as he guns through the keyhole?
Yes, absolutely. Matching shirt. Well, now, David, freedom of speech in this democracy, yes. Anything you want to put straight?
Quite a few things, actually. I can remember Mr. Rushton when he had a brush with democracy in Scotland. He stood as a candidate in a by-election and got, I think, 6 votes, was it?
He got lots of the Liberal Party.
Yes, he did, actually. I'm being unkind.
2,000 to the Liberal Party.
2,000 to the Liberal
Party. Liberal MP, I am your local man, and failed to turn up to a meeting. He got lost.
Well, that's when I first met him. As for Emma...
David, I'm so sorry!
I shall never speak to you again. I thought you'd have recognised the house from the outside. Your father's certainly been there, even if you haven't. No.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean all that about your brass menagerie. I think it's lovely.
What brass menagerie is it, anyway? I never...
And the shrunken heads we were talking about, now, that goes back to your days in Africa,
That's right, yes. A lot of the things you showed are actually from Africa, from the time that I was there.
And doing you still
what?
Speak Swahili?
What were you doing there?
Jumbo? No, no foreign languages here, yes. Right. But what was I doing there? I was at school there, being educated.
Of course, hence the accent.
Yes. She's allowed to do that as a sort of daughter of a Sion, Skion.
A sir,
no less. We didn't see many photographs of David Owen.
Well, that would have given it away, wouldn't it?
Brilliant reply. Now, is it true also, in addition to the thing about good eating, about keen on food?
Yes, I'm afraid that's very perceptive. Your colleague who was up there filming obviously spotted that. Judy's a very good cook. And I must say, the film made the house look very big. I hasten to say it's actually very modest in size. But that dining room, you must have had a long lens on the camera. It made it look enormous.
It looked like a dining room for 14.
No. You can squash at most about 8 or perhaps 10 people in.
Or 2 and Cyril Smith.
Actually, Cyril did stay with us once, and he literally broke the spare bed.
Of all that travelling, and we saw souvenirs around, which was the most memorable place you've been to?
Oh, well, I'm sort of rooted in Africa, I'm afraid, and even though I've been to a lot of places that some people would say are more interesting, I keep being drawn back to Kenya in particular.
Mm. How many countries, I wonder, in the world have you visited?
I would hate to try and count. I have no idea. Quite a large number.
Well, we thank you for sharing your home with us, and we would like you to have this priceless...
That's to go with the brass menagerie, isn't it?
Yes, it's to go in the brass menagerie. Take a bow, Emma. Dave will have another word with you later. And with your father. Later on about that one.
Thank you very much, David Steele. Thank you for being with us. It's been
a delight having you with us. Our thanks to David Steele. We'll take a break and come rushing back. Who's next? See you in a moment.
Who's behind the door? It's number 4.
I like making sure I've got all the right tools for the job.
And now that I'm 50, that means looking after the life I've built. Protecting my life if anything happened to me. That's why I decided to learn more about over 50s life insurance from Cover Today. They're the only over 50s life insurer with no waiting period. Unlike other insurers who could make you wait up to 2 years for full cover, with Cover Today, you're fully covered from day one. And you're covered for the whole of your life. Plus, unlike other things in life, the price never goes up. Learning more couldn't be simpler. Go online or talk to their friendly UK team in just one phone call.
Cover Today are the only over 50s life insurer with no waiting period and no annoying trips to the doctors either. Plus, you get your choice of a £125 gift card.
Cover Today has given me genuine peace of mind. And now that's done, I can get on with something much more interesting.
To find out more about Cover Today, call our friendly UK team on 0800 068 7586 or visit covertoday.co.uk.
My funeral plans arrived.
Oh, right, Mum. Great.
Is your mum all right?
Oh, yeah. She's just,
Granny says she wants to get things sorted now, so we won't have to worry about it.
Oh, it's pure cremation, Jean. Here, have a look. When I go, they'll take care of the practical bit and bring my ashes home. It's all sorted and paid for, so my family won't have the worry. No fuss, no hidden costs. Just what I want.
Oh, I see.
And Granny...